Alright, everyone. So, I have turned down the volume. I'm really hoping this doesn't turn into, like, super loud like it did with the Kingdom Hearts, the first part of Ventus' story. I'm also hoping that's not too low. So, this is kind of an experiment. We'll find out. So, this is a game called, This is the Police. I'm playing it on PlayStation 4. It was originally a Steam game. I had some credits at a GameStop, not a GameStop, it was a local game store chain that I very much prefer to GameStop. But anyway, so I figured we'd give it a try. And I remember...
Usually, before I go shaking my tits for the press, I like to go see how the professionals do it. Some might say the chief of police has no business
in an institution like this. But in fact, it's the quietest and safest place in town. You won't run into any reporters, nobody gets into any fights, nobody drinks too much. Nobody even raises their voice. The place is owned by an elderly gentleman who knows how to keep things under control. That's why I never invite my friends here. I wanted to make an exception for my 60th birthday, but most of my colleagues are young enough to be my sons, and they'd rather just hire prostitutes. Why stare at some boobs when you can take the whole package for yourself? But there's none of that in our club. Even looking too long is considered indecent. You can get an occasional glimpse, like by accident. The rest of the time, you just pretend that you're immersed in conversation, or just come by for a drink. Doesn't mean these gentlemen wouldn't want their bald heads smothered in tits. It's just that nobody says it out loud. My younger colleagues might call it hypocrisy, but I call it the good old-fashioned manners. Good manners and leave the rest unsaid. She agrees to unbutton her blouse and we agree not to pay too much attention. The girls are on a quiet prowl too. They're looking for a way out of their cramped rooms. Maybe make friends with some wealthy patron with a pacemaker and dentures. Everybody wants something. But we have to control ourselves or we'll all turn into libertines and prostitutes. Hell, if there weren't any rules, I'd be belching and farting, jumping up on the table, arms held high, yelling, "Shake it, baby!" No idea how I got so barbaric.
This game before, but we're gonna start a new game. I didn't really watch any of the story elements to it, so that will be something to see. I'm also just going to adjust the game volume a little bit just because it seems like it's a little, well, maybe not since I'll be talking for a good portion of this. So I'll leave it where it is and hope for the best. Hopefully I wasn't too close to the mic for you guys. Anyway, oh, it looks like I'm using my old... So, let's see. Yes, we will be starting a new game. I'm not going to talk at all during the cutscenes, and believe me, there are a lot of cutscenes, and I will talk more about that later.
When I was a kid, my father sometimes told me at bedtime that if I closed my eyes and didn't open them for a long time, all the demons would blow away. Yesterday I turned 60, but I still take his advice. Not because I'm sentimental or want to keep the memory of my father alive. I just can't think of a better solution. To get away from all the demons that haunt Freeburg, I'd need to wear a blindfold 24/7. Plus, it's a good idea to act blind when talking to reporters. At least that's what my colleagues say. They're afraid of press conferences. But for me, it's more like a confessional. No matter what lies you tell, you're privately thinking the honest answers. It helps me remember who I am. The fact that I'll be reading all about it in the papers tomorrow is a small price to pay. Call it penance for the preacher. This is the first time I'm afraid of those answers my mind has given me. Not because I'm mad I'm losing my job. Though it's true, I'm mad as hell. Not because I subconsciously blame everyone else. Though I damn sure do blame them. And don't even ask me what my next move is. I can't imagine. But even that doesn't scare me. The worst thing is, I know I'm gonna have to do something. And I'll be damned if I know how far I'll go. I may have a lot of vices, but predictability isn't one of them. I learned a long time ago how to drive away the swarming demons. But what do you do when they're trying to rip your soul from your skin? Shutting my eyes tight as I can. The best solution remains the same. Play blind. I just hope the reporters think I was blinded by the camera flash.
Alright, so it looks like we're playing now. Good morning. Yesterday, the mayor's office officially announced your resignation. Does this come as a surprise, or did you know about it in advance? Let's see, we don't really want to say we're surprised. I feel like that's kind of not the best thing to admit to. The mayor discussed it with me. I've been expecting this bullshit from the mayor, or what's the difference? Given where I am right now with my current job, my initial instinct is to say I've been expecting this bullshit from the mayor. However, like the kind of, I don't know if I want to call it the diplomatic part of me. Oh gosh, I hope this isn't getting too loud. I don't want to say the mayor discussed it with me though either. I guess I think I'll be a little bit flippant and say, what's the difference? What does it matter whether it came as a surprise? My business is my own. Damn right. Do you already know the name of your successor? No, I think it's a new man. I think it'll be a department veteran. Who cares? So this one, I'm going to say I think it's a new man. And there's no negative connotation to this, but I'm answering it with a negative connotation based on some own personal life things that typically involve people in certain places not respecting the time that someone has given, the service that someone has given to an institution. I think they'll bring in some new blood, a fresh mind to take a fresh look at the problem. And a fresh mind that's easy to mold with the new mayor. Is it a new mayor? I don't know. I don't give a fuck. After the recent corruption scandal, your deputy, Francis Kendrick, said he was looking forward to resigning. If the mayor offered him your position, would that change his mind? How am I supposed to know what would change his mind? That's the thing. So I'm gonna just be flippant here and say who cares. That's his business, not mine. Ask him yourself. That is exactly what I wanted to say. Although Kendrick was acquitted, although Kendrick was acquitted, many still believe that the police are cooperating with the mafia. Do you have anything to say about this? Bullshit, I don't know if it helps the police or no comment. I'm gonna say I don't know. I've never worked with the mafia, but I can't speak for every man and woman in the department. I can't follow all my employees around the clock. Do you think your personal relationship with the mayor could be the reason behind your retirement? Definitely, definitely not. Possibly. How should I know? I'm gonna show my hand a little here and say possibly. It's often difficult to say what guides policy decisions. Thank you. I wonder if the answers would be the same regardless of how I answered them.
How's the bat today, Mr. Boyd?
Same as usual.
How did the press conference go?
You can read about it in the newspapers tomorrow. Don't let anyone in.
Even Mr. Kendrick?
Especially Mr. Kendrick. As soon as I heard the door creak, I knew what face I'd see. When I tell Emma not to let anyone in, there's only one man it could be. Rude, arrogant, no warning. That's Mayor Rogers in a nutshell. White summer shoes, white socks, white shorts, white polo shirt, and the white smile of a hungry shark. Mayor Rogers enters every room like he owns the place. Even the floorboards under his feet sound like they're creaking an apology. He never shied away from the odd corruption scheme. It's like the devil walks behind him. In the movies, the villains controlling the city play golf with the judges. Rogers plays tennis with them instead. That's about the only difference.
Jack! I was hoping to catch you after the press conference. You ran away so quick.
There's no smoking at City Hall. No reason for me to hang around.
Well, this morning I signed a ban on smoking in all public buildings. Soon you won't be able to smoke here either.
Soon enough I won't be here at all.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. The people of this city like you, Jack. The police chief of all people. Don't betray that, Jack. Don't get wrapped up in any schemes. Sit nice and quiet for the next 180 days and you'll be remembered as a hero. That's the only thing that you still have left. Be the hero.
Then how am I supposed to scrape together a retirement fund?
You had a million chances to secure a luxury pension, one that even I would have envied, although I've never set aside any money for myself. I'm not planning to retire anytime soon. Jack. That's all I need. I don't have any problems with you. And you won't have any problems with me. I have a new assistant, Troy Starr. If you have something to tell me, call him. But try not to bother him. He's a busy man.
I'll do my best.
And quit smoking up the office. One of my friends will be using it soon.
Oh, I'm sorry, babe. Only the mayor has this number. Mr. Mayor?
Yeah, is this Troy Starr?
Yes.
Go fuck yourself, Troy Starr.
have to admit, I like our player character here. So, head of the culture department, owns villa in Italy. Civil servants' wages won't be raised this year. That rings a fucking bell. Jack Boyd's resignation had no influence on Francis Kendrick's decision to withdraw from FPD. Why do we have to have that car starting in?
Cops don't use the police station cafeteria
anymore. There's some kind of stigma against sitting shoulder to shoulder with your partners. Everybody just takes snacks from the machines or grabs a meal and hammers it down in the corner like a vulture on a corpse. The main thing? Don't look into anyone's eyes. Could be construed as an invitation to sit together. The only people eating here are ghosts. My deputy, Francis Kendrick, he recently became one of those ghosts. The subject of one of the most devastating corruption scandals in the history of Freeburg. No evidence to support the accusations, but everyone knows Kendrick's days are numbered. I need that file I asked for. Needs to be ready tonight. Francis didn't say anything, but I understood. Ghosts aren't supposed to talk. Besides, I got a feeling he was already finished.
Alright, would you like to receive tips about how the game works? Show me what you've got. I'm a 60-year-old police chief, a few months away from retirement. I don't need anyone telling me how to do my job. Well, here's the thing, I didn't play that far into the game, that's what I've been trying to get at. But there's so many goddamn cutscenes in this game. So I actually haven't played that far into it, so I'm gonna keep the tips on because, I played it for like an hour a couple months ago. So we're gonna go ahead and say, show me what you've got. Freeburg PD organizes upcoming work assignments into shifts for today and tomorrow. Every shift, officers respond to crimes in progress and detectives continue their investigation. You can freely move employees between shifts. Okay. All officers and detectives possess several important characteristics. Professionals. God damn, this text is so small when on like a TV and you're reading it from across the room. Professionalism shows the overall efficiency level of your policemen. I almost called them Pokemon. A figure around 150 is considered average. Any policeman who falls short of this mark is not entirely reliable, while those whose professionalism is considerably higher than average are a safe bet, even in a pinch. An individual's level of professionalism may rise and fall over the course of their career. Energy shows how tired your policemen are. The less energy your people have, the less reliable they work, their work. And a policeman who is exhausted might fall asleep at the wheel or make critical error on the job. Your employees lose 1 point of energy after each working day and restore 1 point after each day of rest. Your employees don't tell you everything. Some additional characteristics are hidden from view. For instance, some cops are lazy and will come up with any reason they can think of to take the day off, while others like to drink too much. You can only guess about these things, but you should be able to draw your own conclusions based on the behavior of your employees. Okay. So it looks like we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cops and 3 detectives. Oh, start the day.